One of the difficulties in understanding air quality is that the pollution that affects your health the most is not the initial component put into the atmosphere.
Under certain atmosphere conditions, some of these pollutants react with each other and produce new harmful agents like ozone.
There's three key ingredients to make ozone: NOx, hydrocarbons, and sunlight.
So think of ozone as an important cleansing agent from the atmosphere. When you have a big stain to clean, you use a lot of cleanser. And when you create a lot of pollution, a lot of ozone becomes evident in the atmosphere. That's helping to clean the atmosphere, but it's also impacting our health. We have primary pollutants. Nitrogen oxides and reactive hydrocarbons are most important in the formation of ozone.
Your car emits both NOx and hydrocarbons, sort of unburned fuel.
But the ozone itself comes from the chemistry, so we call it a secondary pollutant because it results from the chemistry that occurs after the emission of the nitrogen oxides and the reactive hydrocarbons.
When nitrogen oxides and hydrocarbons react with sunlight, they produce a harmful secondary pollutant, ozone. But wait, isn't ozone good for us? Well, it depends.
The role of ozone in the atmosphere is quite complex. In the stratosphere, ozone is a great benefit because it protects us from UV radiation. In the lower atmosphere, ozone is also a benefit because it's responsible for initiating the chemistry that cleanses the pollution out. But when pollution levels are very high, the chemistry runs amok and you create very high levels of ozone. And those ozone levels can become so high that they become reactive with our own body tissues and become a problem in terms of health.
Photochemical smog is considered to be a problem of modern industrialization. It is present in all modern cities, but it is more common in cities with sunny, warm, dry climates and a large number of motor vehicles. It can also affect rural areas, where agriculture, trees, and forest fires can release a considerable amount of volatile organic compounds, or VOCs.
What are the sources of VOCs? Well, we have just the evaporation of gasoline when you're filling your tank. Petrochemical plants, the refineries that are making gasoline from oil, and also the plastic companies that are making plastics, polyethylene, polypropylene.
In terms of reactive nitrogen, man's activity far outpaces the natural sources, and so we can say that when nitrogen oxides are present, that's man. When you talk about reactive hydrocarbons, actually vegetation plays a major global role in creating them.
Trees can emit that pine tree smell you smell, but also a lot of the deciduous trees are emitting isoprene. Isoprene is very reactive and very good at making both particles and ozone.
But fortunately, they create very specific molecules, and when man creates pollution, it creates a different chemical mix. And so we can look at the constituents of the reactive hydrocarbons to determine whether it's nature or whether it's man.
But because these compounds travel with the wind, they can affect different parts of the world. Recently, scientists from other airborne campaigns were able to trace the origin of unusual high levels of ozone in the air above the Western Pacific Ocean. They found that they were linked to the organic compounds released by forest fires in Southeast Asia and Africa, half a world away.
The atmosphere is a shared resource, and we're seeing more and more that the entire Northern Hemisphere is suffering from pollution background levels that are due to all of us, not just one.
Everyone living in a big city around the world is breathing polluted air, and it is having an impact.
It's part of the tug of war between progress and the price that we pay for that progress. And so that balance needs to be maintained into the future. As we continue to develop economically, develop technologically, we have to pay attention to how that's impacting the air quality.
Our world is an interconnected system, and the impact of air pollution goes beyond the air we breathe.
All of the processes that are emitting and causing air pollution are also putting CO2 into the atmosphere, causing climate change, global warming.
It also affects our soils, our glaciers, our oceans, our climate.
And this is a problem that's going to affect our children and our grandchildren. So it's very selfish of us to ignore this long-term problem that is created by us.